Do you want to add awesome, visually attractive, useful documentation to your existing code project? Or even just create a brand new documentation portal completely from scratch? Using MKDocs with the material template, you can easily add a beautiful documentation portal to your project that looks just like this. So in this video, we're going to go through everything you need to get MKDocs with the material template deployed completely from scratch. We'll even be publishing it live on the web through GitHub Pages. So our documentation portal is going to have a ton of cool features. We're going to be able to change the theme between light and dark. We're going to be able to search within our documentation. We're going to have lots of good navigation going on throughout the site. We're going to make our code look beautiful with lots of different highlights. We're going to be able to call out different line numbers, for example, or highlight particular lines in our code. And we'll also see how we can do things like adding different icons into our code as well. And if we look at the bottom here, we're even going to be adding in things like social media callouts as well. So overall, we're going to have a really cool documentation portal that's going to have a ton of really interesting and useful features. So before we begin, let me call out a few prerequisites that you should have installed if you want to follow along with this video. So firstly, you'll want to make sure that you have Python installed, as we're going to be using that to build and to serve our documentation portal. Now we're going to be creating and cloning a brand new GitHub repository, so it'll be useful if you have the GitHub CLI installed, and obviously if you have your own GitHub account. You could probably make do without, but it will be easier if you have that installed. I'm going to be using Visual Studio Code as our IDE. Now you could use another IDE, or you could even use a text editor, but hey, come on, Visual Studio Code is pretty much the best IDE, let's be honest. And that's all you need. Okay, so let's get started by creating a brand new GitHub repository that's going to house our documentation. So I'm here on GitHub inside my default organization. So I'm just going to create a brand new repository for this. I'm going to click the plus sign here and click new repository. I need to give it a name, so let's just call it MKDocs Material YouTube Tutorial. The description we can leave blank. I'll leave it set to public. We'll initialize it with a README. For our gitignore, we'll just choose Python. For our license, we'll just set it to the general public license here. And that should be all we need. So let's just go ahead and hit create repository. Cool, so that's made a brand new empty repository for us. I'm gonna just go ahead and clone this to my desktop. So I'm gonna copy the SSH command here. I've opened up a terminal now and I'm on my desktop. So I'm just gonna do git clone. Paste that repository in. I'm going to cd into the project that I just created. There we go. So before we open up this project in VS Code, let's make a virtual environment with Python. So to do that, we can do python-m venv venv. So that's created our virtual environment. Now we need to activate it. So we can do that with source vmv /bin/activate. I'm going to check that I've got pip installed. So pip is the Python package manager. So I'll just do pip --version. I can see here it's pointing to version 21.2. And now I'm going to install MKDocs. So I'm going to do pip install MKDocs-material. Okay, so it's going to go ahead and download all of the dependencies here for MKDocs material for us. Okay, that should be good. Let's open it up in Visual Studio Code. So to do that, I'm just going to type code dot. And that's opened up Visual Studio Code for me in my project. So let's open up a terminal within VS Code. So I'll just go to terminal, new terminal. You can see that my terminal loads down at the bottom below. And I'm still in my virtual environment because we activated that in the previous step. So now to create a new MKDocs website, I just need to do MKDocs new dot. Oops, not comma, dot. There we go. So I'll hit enter and we can see it's created these two files. So it's created the mkdocs.yaml file and it's also created an initial index.md file. So we can go ahead and run this right away locally. So I'm just going to do mkdocs serve. And we can see here at the bottom, we get a message saying that it's serving on localhost :8000. I'm going to jump over to Chrome and open up that address. And we can see here now that we've got our mkdocs sites being served for us. So again, the documentation inside this index.md, that's what's being served here on our localhost. Now, obviously, this doesn't look too attractive because it's just using the default MKDocs. It's not using MKDocs material. So let's now add in the material plugin and see what a difference that makes to the visualization of the site. I'm going to open the mkdocs.yaml file. Underneath site name, I'll type theme. And the name of my theme is material. Just save that. So when we save that, we can see that our MKDocs site crashed here, probably because it was pulling in the new dependencies. So let's just run this again. So we'll just do MKDocs serve again. And now it's restarted again on the same host, on localhost port 8000. So if I go over to the site again and refresh, And now you can see we've got the MK Docs material theme. You can see how different that looks already. So this is without even any configuration at all, and already you can see how good this looks and how much better it looks than just the plain old MK Docs. You can see we've got like a search box up here, that looks cool. We've got some navigation going on the left. We've got a table of contents here that we can jump around. You can see we've got some code. This has already been annotated, this code. We've got this project layout here. So we've already got some really cool features that we can build upon. So let's head back over to our IDE. Let's start adding a few more options into our MKDocs YAML. So I'm going to change the site name. I'm just going to change that to MKDocs YouTube Tutorial. I'm also going to add a few new features and a bit of different coloring to our theme as well. So I'm just going to paste these in to save some time, but I'll just talk through them. So we're adding these different features. These are to do with navigation. We're enhancing our search a bit with some highlighting. We're adding in code annotations and code copy as well. So we're going to be looking at this in a moment when we add a bit of this to our documentation. We're just making sure that the language is set to English here as well. And we've added a bit of coloring and styling using this palette option. So I'll just save that and I'm just going to jump back over to the documentation. You can see that the colour's changed a bit here. We can see our navigation here has changed a little bit. You can see as well that we've got this option now to be able to change the colour scheme as well. And our search box looks a little different as well. If we try that out, we can search within our documentation. So we can search, for example, for this project layout. So at the moment, we've only got this one page, this index.md. So let's just go ahead and add another page. So within docs, I'm going to add new page. I'll just call this page2.md. And in there, I'm just going to add some really basic markdown. So I'm just adding a header saying page two, another header saying another heading, and just a little bit of example text. Let's jump back over to our site. And we can see now that we've got this page two that's appeared at the top here. And we can see that it's rendering this documentation now for page two. We've got page one, page two. Looks cool. Let's add a few social media icons as well. So I'm going back to my mkdocs.yaml. So I want to have a few social media icons appear in the footer. So to do that, I can just add this configuration here. So I can say extra social, and I've just added in buttons for GitHub, for my Twitter, and for my LinkedIn as well. Again, I'll just save that. If we jump back over to our documentation, we can see that those have appeared at the bottom here as well. These link to my Twitter, LinkedIn, and GitHub repository. Now at the moment, we don't have any copyright message in the footer, so let's go ahead and add that in. So again, in the mkdocs YAML, I'm just going to add this copyright, and I'm just going to paste in my copyright information here like so. Just save that. Jump back over to the documentation. I can see that my copyright information has appeared in the footer. So let's now add a few markdown extensions that will let us do code highlighting and make our code in our documentation look really pretty and attractive. So I'm here again in the mkdocs.yaml. And I'm just going to paste in these markdown extensions here as well. So these are a few extensions that I've just taken from the documentation. And what they're going to do is they're just going to allow us to do some highlighting of our code. So let's save that. And we'll go over to our index.md. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take out this, what we've got here already. I'll change welcome to mkdocs. Let's just change that to homepage. We can leave this link in here from the mkdocs documentation. That's fine. So let's add a few code annotation examples. Let's add another heading. Let's just call this one code blocks. So you can put some code in line by just using backticks. So let's just say some code goes here. Let's save that and let's go and have a look at what it looks like. So we can see here we've got our text and it's just highlighting that code there for us. That looks cool. That's a really basic way of just highlighting some code. Let's look at as well as how we can add an entire code block. So let's say I wanted to have a plain code block. Say a plain code block. To do a whole code block, you need to do 3 backticks. And then we'll put some code in. And I'm just going to make up some random code, def my function. This code doesn't make much sense, that's okay. I'm going to do the 3 backticks as well to close. Let's save this. So now we've got an actual code block that's appeared here as well. You can see as well we've got an option here to copy this code to our clipboard. So that's because we added in that extra annotation into our mkdocs.yaml. So we can also add in code for a specific language. So I'm just going to paste this in to save some time. But here we're going to have some code with Python at the start. So because we put this py just after our three backticks, and we put in some Python code, if we save this, we can see now that this has been properly highlighted as Python code. So instead of py, there's lots of different annotations that you could put in for lots of different code. So I'll leave a link in the documentation below if you want to see some of the different ones that you can call in. But there's hundreds that you can literally call in for every different language. It's really cool. See as well how we can add some code with a title. So this time I want to give my code a title. I want the title of the code to be bubblesort.py, and then I've just pasted in some random code in here. So we can see this time our code block's got this title. We've got all of our code here nicely formatted. That looks pretty. We could also add in line numbers as well. So this time I've just called out, we want line nums number one. So we want it to start, the line numbers to start from number one. Let's save that and see what that looks like. Oops, I haven't done that correctly. I missed out the last three backticks. Let's just add those in. So I've got three backticks, save that. Okay, that looks better. So this time our code block has got line numbers down the side. We could also highlight whole lines as well. So this time we want to highlight lines 2 and 3. So we've got the same Python method here, but we want to highlight lines 2 and 3. Let's save that. So here you can see this time lines 2 and 3 have been highlighted. That looks really cool. So yeah, there's just a few basic examples of some of the code highlighting that you can do. Now there are tons of other options that you can do. Again, I encourage you to have a look around the documentation, see the different things you can do, but there's loads of other options. Before we publish our site, let's just have a quick look at how we can add emojis and icons as well. So I'm just going to paste this code in here. So here I'm just calling out a smiley. I just want to have a face with a laughing wink. I'm using the Twitter icon as well, and a love heart here as well, because why not? Let's save that. So here we've got our different icons coming up here. So you might find these useful, you might not, but it's pretty cool that you can add these to your documentation. So again, I'll leave some links to the Markdown documentation where you can see all of the other cool different things you can do with icons. There's literally loads of different things you can do. It's really cool. So if we look here on the left, we can see as we've been adding in all of these different headers and codes, we've been building out our navigation bar here, and it's all nicely styled. So we can just click on here and we can just jump to a specific point in our documentation. Okay, so now we've had a look at a few of the different features of the documentation. So let's go and see how we can actually put this live on our GitHub pages. So in order to get our documentation to publish on GitHub, what we need to use is we need to use GitHub Actions. And this will take care of publishing our documentation for us. So let's see how to add that in now. So what I need to do is I just need to create a new folder. Just give that a name of .github. Within that GitHub folder, we just create another folder of workflows. Within that workflows, we make a new file, give it a name of ci.yaml. I'm just going to paste in the CI code that we need here. So what this basically does is this is the GitHub Actions code. So it just listens for pushes to the master or main branch. When it detects those, it does the work of installing mkdocs material, and it does the work of publishing to our GitHub pages. So this is all that we need. And again, I've just taken this from the mkdocs material documentation. So let's just go ahead and save that file. So now we're ready to push this back up to our GitHub repository. So I'm going to open up a new terminal again. So I'm going to commit. So I'm going to add all my files, I should say, to a commit. So I just do git add dots, do git commit dash m. Let's just say adding initial documentation files. Looks good. And we're just going to push this directly to our main branch. So I'll just do git push origin main. Okay, if we jump back over to GitHub, if I just refresh the page, we can see here that our files have been updated. Now, before we publish to GitHub pages, we do need to set up a setting. So if you click on settings here, click on pages, and then under this GitHub pages, we need to choose a source. So we're going to say source will be deploy from a branch. From the branch, we just choose this GitHub pages. And this GitHub pages branch has been created by the GitHub automation or for the GitHub actions that we just uploaded. So click on GitHub pages. That root is fine. Then we just hit save like so. It's good. If we go over to actions now, if we click on CI, we should have some details of the job that just ran that did the publishing of our GitHub pages. So if we click on deploy, we can see all of the logs here that ran. If we click on this run mkdocs deploy log, and we can see here we get a message saying your documentation should be available on this site shortly. So if I go over to this address now, you can see that now we've got our documentation, which is the same thing that we were working on locally. and that's been published to this address. I don't like this theme much, I'm just going to change it over to the dark theme. That looks so much better for me. Hopefully now you can see how easy it is to get some documentation published on GitHub at a live address. So in this video, we covered deploying a brand new documentation portal from scratch using MKDocs with the Material plugin. And we're really only scratching the surface in this video of what you can do with MKDocs and the Material plugin. There's loads of other features to explore. You can find out more about them by looking through their extensive documentation or through looking through the community. They've got a really active community on GitHub as well. There's also a ton of really cool features that you can get as a paid subscriber as well. So they've got a really interesting model of how they have subscribers and how they release new features to their subscribers. So one of the cool features, for example, is that you can actually host an entire blog using MKDocs and the Material plugin, which is really cool and something that I'm planning to explore in the future as well. So yeah, this video was quite a basic overview of MKDocs. I just wanted to show you some of the really basic features and most importantly, how you can just get it deployed live. But if there's interest in having a more in-depth video, please do let me know and I'd be happy to make one. But anyway, I hope you found this video useful. As always, if you have any comments, just let me know below. But otherwise, see you in the next one.